Welcome back to Bangers Bricks, everybody. My name is Ben. Today we are going out getting materials so we can finally put up the shelving in the Lego room. I know we've been talking about it for a little while as we have run out of room in the Lego room, so it is time to expand, get some more room for some of our display sets or any sort of modular sets that we can't fit into the Lego city. So I'm excited to finally get this done. The other thing, we're going to try to get all of the shelving up, but if we don't get a chance, we may end up taking a couple special projects on within the greener area and finally filling things in there as well. So let's see what we can get to today. And don't forget to like, subscribe. Please drop a comment down below as we're going as well. Please let me know what your thoughts are, if there's anything you'd like to change, but let's get started. All right, everybody, we're hanging out here at Home Depot and just want to give you a little bit more insight as to what materials we purchased and used to build the shelves in the Lego room. So first off, I want to tell you about one problem that I ran into that was just kind of a brain fart for me. Is I was thinking, right, a base plate is 10 inches deep. I'm just going to go 10 inch deep shelves. And so we ended up buying the 10 inch deep Rubbermaid shelves. And the one thing I completely forgot to look at is what is the actual depth? The actual depth is 9.8 inches and then it's 71.8. So 6 feet by 9.8 inches. So kind of a bummer there, because when you have a 10 inch long bracket, you're actually going slightly past the actual shelf. Even if it lined up perfectly, I'm still gonna have to bump it out about 3/8 of an inch. So kind of a bummer there. So what we're doing is we're actually exchanging, we have in store credit to buy the 12 inch depth shelves. I'll talk a little bit more about why we went with the 12 inch versus the 10 inch, minus the fact that it's not actually 10 inches, but just a little bit of the difference in how we are going to use our string lighting, because we're actually going to need, we're still gonna be using the 10 inch brackets, but what we'll do is actually have just that little bit of a seam here, or a little bit of a gap, so that we can put the string lighting all the way along the edge to create a little bit more lighting for the second tier. So let's buy these and let's get out of here. Now that we have the boards and the brackets for the shelving in the Lego room, it is time to start going around and marking off where all of these studs are. And as you can see, I have already gotten started. We are going to be using the painter's tape on the wall, primarily because I don't want to mark up the wall. So we'll put the painter's tape where we think the studs are, and then I'll go around and mark the exact height and the exact center of the stud, just so that we're making sure we have a ton of support underneath all of our Lego sets that we'll be putting up on the shelving. We are going to be using our stud finder here to just make sure that we get the center of the stud. I do like this one because, again, it's not just giving you, not just beeping, but it's actually giving you the actual width of the stud when you do find it. So that will be super helpful. The last thing I want to talk about is really just the change in height that we have within the Lego room. One thing is we're working with a ceiling that does have a bit of a slope in the corner. So one dimension that I was thinking of working with was 29 inches from the ceiling all the way down to the top of our shelving. Primarily how I came up with 29 inches is the Disney castle is right around 29 inches. So if I do end up getting both Disney castles and I want to put both of them up there, which I probably will, I'll create some sort of Disney shelving here, and then both of the Disney castles can sit here. Now, it's not going to be 29 inches on our long wall here, because with the slope, it actually comes down and will end up being right around like 16 and a half to 17 inches. So we'll have about 17 inches of clearance from the top of the wall to the top of our shelving on our long wall here. That will be very beneficial. And then if we do decide to connect it over here, again, we'll have right around 29 inches to place a larger set over in that area. And then in the end, what we're also going to be doing is adding in some string lighting underneath to just add a little bit more of an effect and really just create more lighting on top of the second tier in the Lego city itself. But let's get started. Let's mark off all those studs. The next step is complete. We not only have the painter's tape where the studs are, but we also went through, marked the center of the stud, and also where 29 inches is down from the ceiling. Now, I was going to go with a bracket every other stud, but my father-in-law had a great point as to it's only half inch thick. The shelving is only half inch thick. And so with it being half inch thick, if we go every other, I'm worried that we'll get too much bowing. So we really want to have as much support as possible. So we're actually going to end up putting a bracket under each stud or in each stud, just so we have much more support, create less bowing. Now, as we're putting our first bracket in the corner here, we will use our larger level so that we can make sure that our shelving is level. And then we'll be using our 10 inch deep brackets. All right, let's get started. Last night got a little out of hand, look at my hands, dear. I fell off a soapbox, I can't understand it. I've been on a tangent here on this planet. Now I'm on a transit to anywhere else now. Headed for a breakdown, need a little break now. What else can I say about what I've done and what I'm gonna do? Ooh. Here's the reveal for the first shelf that we put up in the Lego room. So looking pretty good so far. The one thing I will say is that the walls are very warped, and I'll show you a quick example of that. As you can see, we have our bracket here that is sitting flush up against the back wall and coming straight back out at us. Now, if you look at the actual shelf, we have the little bit of a gap coming out here, and you can kind of see the little V that it makes. Just the wall is coming straight back out, turning to our left here a little bit, but the bracket is coming straight back out at us. So we were able to use just a little bit of a template here and a square to try to figure out what kind of cut we were going to have to make and what adjustments we were going to have to make while we're cutting. So that is pretty solid overall. It's pretty level. I think it looks great. The one thing I am a little concerned about is in the corner here, how you can kind of see how the board is warped just a little bit here. It kind of goes up and then back down in the corner. What I'll end up having to do is taking just a little connector piece that connects both this shelf and the shelf that will go on the larger wall here. Connect those together. The only other question that I'm trying to figure out is how I'm going to support that back corner, whether or not I put a bracket that's going along the longer wall or on the shorter wall. I think I'll go along the longer wall, and then we'll have another bracket that will sit just on the other side of the Daily Bugle, and then we'll go every single stud this way. We are going to have to get more brackets, so I'm not 100% sure if we will get the longer shelf done today, but I think this is a pretty good start and gives us something to work with. I've made the decision. I think we're going to stop here for the day. I know it wasn't a ton of work, but there was a decent amount of work that obviously went into it, and purchasing the materials, getting the brackets, putting the brackets up, then cutting the shelving, putting it up. But now we really have a good idea as to how we're going to attack the larger wall. It won't be one board because obviously it's only 6 feet long and we have about 92 inches left on this wall. So it'll end up being two boards that'll be cut at about 46 inches to fit the rest of the wall. The primary reason I'm going to stop is it's really hard to go over to my father-in-law's, you know, borrow his stud finder as mine was misplaced a little while back. So I just need to go out buy another one, and that way I can go back and just finish it off myself. Now, that doesn't necessarily mean we're done for the day. I do have one other small little project that I wanted to do. We bought some of these brown fence pieces, thought it would go well with the A-frame cabin. We'll put some of these little wood tiles that we got, make it look like some stumps. And then we'll also be putting some of these pumpkins over by the A-frame, and then putting some of these animals inside of our fence. So let's get working on that, and then we'll be done for the day. I completely forgot to mention that we already decided that we are going to take the A-frame cabin, which was up on our second tier that we had built, brought it down to our little greenery area down here beneath our rock ledge, and really just start building around that. What's going to take its place is going to be the haunted house, and that is going to be in one of our next videos as well. Excited to build that, really get into the spirit of Halloween, and start filling this bad boy out. This is looking so much better. I really like the little brown fence that we have on the outside of the A-frame cabin. I love the other cool details that we have. We have a little bunny on the inside. We have a couple sheep, couple little piggies. We've got a couple little lambs. And then we're obviously trying to get into the Halloween spirit. Got some pumpkins. And then again, I think just the greenery that we've added with the different trees and bushes so far, just in the greenery area on this one little spot, is just really making it come to life. I know it does block a little bit of the rock ledge, but I think that that is just a natural way of, you know, greenery and shrubs and trees that are all kind of growing around some of these different modulars or sets, again, is just going to make it look so much more realistic. Now, Winnie the Pooh still needs a lot of work done around it, but definitely something that we'll have to address in the upcoming videos. But again, overall, I love these little wood printed tile pieces here, these rounded, you know, 1x1 and 2x2 reddish brown tile pieces. Thought those were super cool. Again, just gives it a little bit more of effect of, since they have the wood burning stove inside of the A-frame cabin, really thought, hey, you need wood. So we have some of that. Again, they chopped it down. I tried to include a couple different types of trees, you know, with the cylinder pieces and then also the 2x2 rounded bricks. So I thought that was pretty cool. And then again, we're going to address a bunch more coming up here. And then, as I mentioned, we'll be figuring out what we're going to do here. We're going to be putting that haunted house and then really just kind of bringing this to life up here. We need to start looking at putting more green plate, green tile down so we can tile and plate around some of the different sets that we have up here. So a lot to do, but again, a lot of time left to do it. Although we weren't able to get all of the shelving up in the Lego room, we were able to get out, get all of our materials, put one of our shelves up, and attack a couple projects within the greener area. I'm excited as we have a lot coming up here over the course of the next couple weeks. We have the haunted house being built, we have a couple more projects within the greener area, putting in the rest of the river, putting in a couple more modulars, and getting the rest of the shelves up in the Lego room is obviously our first and foremost. Got to get that done because the sets that we buy going forward are going to have to go up on the shelves, or it's going to have to replace something in the Lego City, and then those are going to have to go up on the shelves. So that is kind of our number one goal here, but we do have a lot left to do, and I'm excited to do that. Please make sure you guys like, subscribe, and stay tuned for more. I'll see you guys later. Have a great rest of your week.